My name is Amanda Bambrick, and I have a Bachelor of Science degree in Agricultural Environmental Science from Dalhousie University, and I have a Master's degree from McGill in Natural Resource Sciences. Right now I work as a strategic analyst for the Government of Alberta. I work in Alberta Energy, and my job is to understand all of the priorities within the government and know how they connect. A lot of people, when they're working on a project, get so deep into the details of what it is that they're interested in that they often forget to take a moment to step back and think, how do these connect? Why am I working on this? And what other factors can my work affect that I'm not looking at right now? And my job is to be able to step back and be aware of that and connect to the right people to talk about those issues. When I started out studying, I thought I was on track to become a science professor in a university. So for summer jobs, and I was doing extra research projects on the sides, environmental research projects, I was working in an environmental research lab for the federal government, and then I did my master's in natural resource sciences. However, when I finished those studies, I came out to Alberta, and I started working as an environmental consultant. And that was really interesting because it was the switch between coming from pure science to applied science to using it in industry. And that was neat, but I wanted to switch to government and work in climate change. A scientist is trained to pay attention to the details in their work, and they're also trained to constantly pay attention to all the outside factors beyond what they're looking at that may impact what's important to them right now in this moment. And it's something that you think about so much in your role in science that it comes naturally. And going out into the workforce, I've realized that's not something that comes naturally to a lot of people. So that's a great skill to bring of, in my work, we call it systems thinking of, we're not only thinking about this one problem that we're talking about today, it's impacted by and impacting so many different things out there. And if we're going to, as government, for example, where I'm working, make good policy, we need to have that skill. So when you walk into a job interview with a science degree, that's a skill that you're bringing that you're not even thinking about normally, and also something to remember. And another thing is that scientists are trained to be very detailed-oriented people who understand process. And so you could go to a job interview saying, I know how to do scientific experiments. That may not be very helpful to an employer. But to go into a job interview and say, I know how to work through a complex problem to come out with a solution, and I have the grit to stick with it until I walk out with a solution, is something that's very valuable. Research has shown again and again that people are the most engaged and the most successful in their jobs whenever they're working with their strengths. So you need to figure out what your strengths are. Work on your weaknesses too, but find a job and find the type of roles where you'll be using your strengths every day, because that's when you're going to be happy at work. The best advice that I've received is to learn how to embrace change in the workplace. Because someone who's able to gracefully accept change and deal with it, both in their projects or their career in general, is someone who's heavily sought after in the job market. And also to help support that, to help you learn how to embrace change, also be open to lateral moves in your career. You don't always need to move up. Moving sideways and doing different types of jobs can give you a broad type of experience to help you A, find the type of work that you really like, and B, bring forth a whole bunch of skills that you can take to any job and be able to take on any project.